Welcome to Navigating with HIN from the Hospital Improvement Innovation Network team at the Iowa Healthcare Collaborative. My name is Lana Comstock, and thank you for joining us. Today we're going to have Jennifer Nutt from the Iowa Hospital Association here to help us understand the Chief Nursing Officer role in hospital quality. Jen has her doctorate in nursing practice, and she serves as the Director of Nursing and Clinical Services for the Iowa Hospital Association. Jen leads the hospital-based nursing profession in advocacy and education. She provides facilitation in the areas of clinical research, quality, patient safety, and related services for the Iowa Hospital Association member hospitals and health systems. Jen serves as the liaison with various national and state nursing organizations, quality organizations, and as the IHA spokesperson on nursing and clinical service issues. Well, Jen, thank you so much for taking the time out of your busy schedule to join us today and have a conversation around hospital leadership engagement to drive quality. Today, I wanted to kind of focus on the HIN measures that are primarily nursing driven. So, Jen, how would you see the chief nursing officer role around driving nursing measures, specifically those HIN measures that we have?
Thanks, Lana. First, I want to say thanks for having me here today. It's my pleasure to be here and talk with you. I see the chief nursing officer as the person leading nurse-driven measures. The CNO should be engaging with their quality and nursing staff to track measures and trends. And the CNO should also be helping identify if there are negative trends and directing quality and nursing staff to start work groups or task force to identify where the gaps are to determine what is the best improvement project to implement and start the implementation. Along with this, the CNO also needs to be ensuring that staff are engaged in quality work and whatever new implementations are put in place based on negative trends, following up to make sure that improvement is being seen.
Well, that's great. So Jen, next I would like to ask you, in using some of the examples of our measures that are nursing driven, like falls and pressure injuries, how does the nursing plan of care drive quality outcomes?
Well, I think measures like fall and pressure ulcers are great examples of the impact that nurses can have on quality measures. Basic patient care like skin assessments, skin care, and turning patients should be part of every patient's care plan. And as for falls, patient safety is always a priority for all patients in their plan of care. With both of these measures, as well as with other measures, nurses need to be educating patients on the importance of falls, pressure, injury, and other safety measures. And the second part of that is nurses need to be educating patients enough so patients are engaged in their care while they're in the hospital and patients are helping to develop their plan of care in the hospital and after discharge.
So how can nursing leadership then facilitate nursing staff to promote those best practices?
I think one of the main ways nursing leadership can really encourage staff is to encourage engaged staff by promoting and providing educational opportunities for staff to learn new evidence-based practices. And this can be done through going to conferences, engaging in webinars, a variety of different ways that nurses can get education, even having nursing journals available for nurses to read, as well as encouraging nurses to develop an implementation plan for best practices and supporting their staff nurses in doing so, and make sure that the evaluation process is going on afterwards to ensure that the best practices implemented have improved patient outcomes.
That's excellent. Who should really be responsible for data collection for the trending and identification of the different priority areas of focus?
Thanks, Lana. That is a detailed question. So there are many people responsible for data collection, for trending and identification of priority areas. And this goes on all throughout the hospital, not just in nursing units. All members of the interdisciplinary team have a role in this, from nursing to lab to pharmacy to medicine to physical therapy, occupational therapy. Everyone who is having connections and impacting patient care really needs to be part of this job. Each discipline is responsible for collecting their own data because they have their own interventions and measure they track. But this needs to be communicated to all the other team members. And I really feel that's where nursing leadership, chief nursing officers, really have a role to bring all these people to the same table. If it's quality huddles, team huddles, whatever each organization calls it, Each interdisciplinary team member needs to be at the table discussing what they're seeing in their data, how that's relating to other areas of the hospital to identify what the priorities should be for that organization.
Great information, Jen. I know that working toward a culture of engagement with a patient safety focus has been a huge priority for our HIN hospitals. So I was wondering, as we close today, how you see nursing managers and executives working with the quality departments to assure this focus.
Thanks, Lana. A culture of engagement can be tricky to measure. I think nursing leaders need to be working with their nursing quality departments to assess the perception of engagement with the patient safety focus in the organization. And this can be done in a variety of different ways to assess engagement. As with other initiatives, continuous feedback and loop closure is essential to ensure patient safety is a focus. I think that a culture of engagement with patient safety needs to be defined. It can be hard to measure engagement if staff, patients, everyone within an organization does not understand what the meaning behind culture of engagement is. And once that is defined, the nursing and quality staff are able to identify areas of opportunities that are not meeting this definition and determine what needs to be implemented for it to be successful.
Well stated. I really want to thank you today for joining us and giving us this overview for hospital leadership, specifically the nursing leader's role in quality, focusing as we have on the quality outcomes for patient care so we can drive that culture of safety. Thank you, everyone, for joining us in this episode on the role of the hospital leader in driving quality. Please remember the Iowa Healthcare Collaborative's Compass HIN team is here to assist you in your quality works, so feel free to reach out anytime.